Good morning, friends. I am again with the chapter 4, class 6, science, that is sorting materials into group. Now come to the properties of material. The first property here is appearance. Appearance, how the material looks like, hard, soft, raw, smooth, these are the appearance. So come to the activity 3. Collect some piece of different materials like paper, cardboard, wood, copperware, aluminium sheet, chalk. Do any of these appear shiny? Separate the shiny material into a group. If we group into these materials, shiny and drop surface, so we keep shiny materials into one group and other materials which are not shiny in another group. Now observe as the teacher cuts each material into two pieces and look at the freshly cut surface. So, what do you notice? Does the freshly cut surface of some of these materials appear shiny? Include these objects also in groups of shiny materials. Do you notice such a shiny or luster in the other materials? Cut them anyway as you can. Repeat this in class with as many materials as possible and make a list of those with or without luster. Instead of cutting, you can drop the surface of material with sandpaper to see if it has luster. So we see that in iron objects or iron coming in contact with moisture and air, it becomes rusted. If we rub this rusted surface with sandpaper, it becomes shiny. And if we break the chalk into two pieces, the breaking surface will more shiny. So by this way we can make the surface and appearance of the material shiny, but it is especially in case of metals. So here the materials that have such luster are usually metals. Iron, copper, aluminium and gold are examples of metals. Some metals often lose their shine and appear dull because of the action of air and moisture on them. We therefore notice the luster only on their freshly cut surface. When you visit an iron smith or a workshop, look out for freshly cut surface of metal rods to see if they have luster. Yes, they have luster. So next, second property is hardness. By seeing some material, we can also assume or touch by touching the material, we can feel it is whether hard or soft. Here, this is the pen. If we compress it, we cannot compress the pen because it is hard. If we put more pressure, it will break down. So it is a hard material. If we compress a cotton ball or some piece of cotton, it will press in and decreases in size. So pressure applied to it changes its size, but it is in case of soft material, not in hard material. So hardness. When you press different materials with your hand, some of them may be hard to compress while other can easily compressed. Take a metal key and try to scratch it with the surface of a piece of wood. Aluminium, a piece of stone, a nail, candle, chalk, any other material or object. You can easily scratch some materials while some cannot be scratched so easily. Materials which can be compressed or scratched easily are called soft, while some other materials which are difficult to compress are called hard. For example, cotton or sponge is soft while iron is hard. So according to hardness, there are two types of materials, that is, one is soft material and another is hard material. Soft material is easy to compress and hard material is difficult to compress. In appearance, metals can have different properties like luster, hardness, be rough or smooth. So next come to the next property, that is solubility of the material, whether the material is soluble or insoluble. Come to the activity 4. Collect samples of some solid substances, such as here solid substances are taken, that is sugar, salt, chalk powder, sand and sawdust. Take 5 glasses. So we take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 materials. So we take 5 glasses or 5 beakers. Fill each one of them about 2/3 with water. Add a small amount of spoonful of sugar to first glass, salt to second, and similarly we add other materials, small amounts of other substances into other glasses. Stir the contents of each of them with spoon. Wait for few minutes. Observe what happens to the substances added to water. Notice your observation as well. Here water disappears or doesn't. We have to see what happens with the 5 substances when we add these substances in water. Here is the table is given. Substance, first substance is salt. So disappear in water or doesn't disappear? Disappears completely in water. Salt. Then sugar is also disappear completely in water. You also see it. Sand is settled down, it doesn't mix with water, so it cannot disappear. Chalk powder is also same like sand, it also settled down after some time of stirring the water, then it doesn't mix completely with water. Sawdust is also settled down and doesn't mix. So this sand, chalk powder, sawdust are insoluble, while sugar and salt are soluble. It is mixes with water and disappears completely. Here you will notice that some substances has completely disappeared at dissolving water. We say that these substances are soluble in water. Other substances do not mix with water and do not appear even after stir for a long time. These substances are insoluble in water. So according to the property of solubility, materials are 2 types. One is soluble material and other is insoluble material. Water plays an important role in functioning of our body because it can dissolve a large number of substances. That's why water is called universal solvent or universal solvent, because it can mix much more materials in the body and also in our surrounding. So next, thank you friends for watching this. In my next video, I will discuss other properties of the materials. Bye.